I've been waiting for this one. Turn it up.
So since Remnote has been updated, there are a lot of teas being spilled.
How to make knowledge compound and to splash or save 6 spicy dalumnos on the pro version. Let's find out.
Hello, welcome back. My name is Priscilla. If you're new here, nice to meet you and hope you like this new setting. And our tradition is story time. When my new semester began in September, my relationship with note-taking and studying was a complete disaster. I don't like rules and deadlines. I value freedom and the ability to control my time with my powers of guilt, anxiety, and discipline. The gut instinct called me, like tapped on my leg. Hey.
Suppress 65 million years of gut instinct.
There was something wrong with copying what the professor says verbatim, from the recording to my Remnote notes. And my other class this year is neural anatomy. Am I supposed to apply neural anatomy to my brain, to myself, and I can dissect it so I can study my brain? Fun fact, brains not have brain receptors. But how can I internalize those wisdom from social psychology, developmental psychology, and neural anatomy in those academic settings into my life to problem solve and to critical think? I hate blindly memorize stuff just for the test, and after the semester everything disappear. My tens of thousands of tuition fee just goes into the school and... The 8th wonder of the world is, say with me kids, compound effect. Since January 2017, the Remnote founder has started to code Remnote. And this app starts growing from his coding hands. He named this prototype version of Remnote called Live Notes. The nerd learning community has a great response. He noticed that he was not the only person who was facing this problem, but many others are too. And how I discovered Remnote? Thanks to the god of YouTube's algorithm. I discovered Remnote from a YouTuber called Notes with Ren. So since then, Remnote has a major update. I had to relearn parts of the app. I'm a growing, evolving stub of tree. Wow. I try to follow a set of perfect formulas to build a system for my note management and studying methods in school. Does something like this actually exist? I started to read through the Remnote update log and learn it myself. After we have registered and logged in into Remnote, on a sidebar, first we will see the tag all notes, a queue that have changed to flashcard now. Edit later, this is where you can put your flashcards when you want to edit or add new information to them. And then pinned, finished, and then draft. And in the corner, the three dots is where we can access the menu to practice our RAMs with space repetition or not, share our document, print it. The blank middle part is where we type our notes into a long list of bullet points. And then if you want to create a new document, click on the purple button at the corner, three options appear.
After the daily document has been created, it will be populated under drafts.
This is where our day begins with Remnote, the holy grails of the daily document. The shortcut to open this up is Option plus D. So here there are some handy dandy commands to help you get started. The first one is Command slash, which brings up the Omnibar. This Omnibar just shows all of the available functions that the Remnote has to offer. And then the second one, they call the editor. You can change the heading size, highlight, color. Some other things are, you can move this rem to another different organizational hierarchy, or look at your flashcard properties into a list of 1, 2, 3, and 4, to-do list. Copy this rem as a reference or a portal. There are many things that you can do with this. Now I have a clear guide with my to-do list to get my day started. Otherwise, I'll just wander in my thoughts and never get out of my lazy mind. I was in the honeymoon phase with this app. There were so many new terminologies, but thank god everything can be accessed in the Omnibar or the slash menu editor. And yes, I stubbornly just call it the slash menu.
It's really... The point in arguing about this is that you just...
Because you just type a slash. Isn't that easier for you to memorize? So my little midterm for neural anatomy class is inching up in 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 weeks. I love learning, but memorizing arbitrary facts in windowless classrooms for 8 hours straight is just not fun. But still stay in school, kids.
Dad, it's time for school!
When I had a call with my friend, we were discussing about what the connectome was. She asked a question to me, what is the connectome? I just regurgitated the definition to her, which is, connectome is a complete description of a structural connectivity of an organism's nervous system. And then she's like, huh? Can you explain that in simpler terms? She started to ask me many other questions, like the purpose of the connectome. Why do humans want to map the brain?
In the end, she had a better understanding than I did. It's so obvious and simple. It's about asking the right questions.
I have an extreme love and hate relationship for flashcards.
As students, to grasp the tool and not memorize and have creativity throughout the phases of learning the interface of this new design app, I realized that my system wasn't working and there was no perfect system for me as a student. I have to design my own. The key thing here was note-taking versus note-making. Note-making is the generation effect. I'll put a paper here of the definition of generation effects.
It works because you actively produce material when you are encoding. So to design a system ourselves, we need to learn the building blocks.
Different types of flashcards when we are note-making instead of note-taking. So remember that I have mentioned the difference between note-taking and note-making. So in this new design, Remnote has scratched its concept and descriptor framework.
They have kept the
parent-child method. Just think of them as things housing under a big umbrella. For example, a neuron will go under neural anatomy. The first type of flashcard is the basic card. There are three subtypes of it.
The flashcard is triggered by the
little arrow key thing. I call them sleeping Vs because there are Vs on their back. I hope that makes sense. Double-sided flashcard, this is a backwards flashcard if you're writing this direction from the definition to the term. And this one is a forward card. I can preview those flashcards by moving my cursor onto the arrow. So here, in this example, I use the basic flashcard for explaining what a neuron is. So neurons are the basic functioning units in a nervous system. And then the next type of flashcard is multi-line flashcard. So how can I trigger this type of flashcard? The shortcut is two colons and enter. I use this one to explain parts of the neurons. The parts of the neuron are under the neuron line, so they're nest below the term neuron. And this segue us to the next type of flashcard, which are descriptor cards. Descriptor cards means that breaking down parts of the bigger terminology, and this one I can generate it with two semicolons. And the term will not be bolded, instead it will be italicized. I describe what dendrites, axons, axon terminal bundles, myelin sheath, and Schwann cells are. And then the next type is image occlusion, because when we're learning anatomy, we want to add images. So here is a picture that I've inserted of a neuron. I command click on the photo and drag parts I want to cover, and then the color will be changed into a blue box. The next type is a fill in the blank, or the reptile terminology likes to call it close again. Type the squiggly brackets. You type it and then the text background will be in light blue. So here I have dug out keywords in my sentences such as the human's neocortex has 6 layers and what is the connectome. So I can be really creative here and choose what words I want to dug out. And then the next type of card is lists. Whenever there are a list of things that you must memorize in that particular order, those flashcards come into handy. I describe the action potential using this type of flashcard. Like the first step is resting membrane potential is at -5 millivolts, and then when a stimuli comes, this sodium channel opens and depolarizes, and then potassium channels open, and then the resting membrane potential repolarizes again. Sodium potassium pump will bring back the membrane potential to -55 volts. And when I take my notes, I already sound so academic. Kind of just strips away the interest and curiosity of me learning in neuroscience and anatomy. As a responsible student who's lazy and falls back on a system, I just mindlessly scroll through my flashcards and retain all those information. So what's spaced repetition for you guys who don't know? Sorry, I'm cracking my toes. So spaced repetition is the process of spacing out your studies in gradual intervals as I get more familiar with this concept. So if I want to practice the document that I've created now, I will click on the three buttons in the corner and say practice REM with spaced repetition. And then this screen will appear with your flashcard in the middle where the app has shuffled it for you and four emojis at the bottom. So if I feel like a badass queen, I will click on the crown. I can recall this with ease. If I'm a breeze and I can recall it with minimal effort, I will boop smile emoji. If I freeze and smile awkwardly and don't know what to answer, I will smash the cracked face emoji. And then if I feel anxious and my butt is on fire, I will smash the X. That means that I cannot recall it. If you find this video helpful to your studies, take a magic wand and sparkle that like button to a blue color. This helps the algorithm to spread this video to more people who can. After reading the story of how Remnote has started, I do not completely agree with it. It's not finding about the most efficient tools and memorizing and being really productive. If the human brain worked and studied for 10 to 12 hours straight, the interest and curiosity just get killed. I mean that a tool is great, but I'm not taking ownership of my learning. When I'm self-motivated, curious, the superpowers of learning really comes in. So to apply those wisdom to life, it's not just about memorizing them 10 to 12 hours straight before an exam and completely forgetting them. So since that learning is about connecting those dots and building those knowledges, Remnote even has this function for us. And with this update version, things are even smoother. So first, when we highlight any text, the Remnote app will automatically search up this exact same word that it appears in other places in the database. This is a good place to begin when I want to start synthesize and connect my notes with my other subjects. So the first basic type of references is called rem references, and in other apps, it's called bidirectional linking. Best analogy that I can give for bidirectional linking is the difference between parasocial relationship and real life relationships. In parasocial relationships, we have a one-way relationship to a celebrity, like what I do all the time because I have no boyfriend. It's monolinking. In real life relationships, we know each other's existence. So that's what bidirectional linking is.
Hey yo,
you.
Yes, you. I'm referencing you.
Huh? I know you're referencing me. Rem references are used with a double bracket, and I can link them when there's a particular term that I mentioned. And this term will be in a light navy blue text.
The reference and the date of creation will appear at the bottom of the document
in a light navy blue text. And then the next type of references is portals. Portal's best analogy is a teleporting door. You can open it and go to that note's location directly. And if I update the note in the original place, it will update in another place. And they have completely redesigned this with a light blue border around it, so it doesn't clog up with your document. It is better for referencing a block. It can be triggered by bypassing two parentheses brackets. And after you have structured knowledge, you can look at the relationships of one document to other documents by clicking on the three dots and just click on view graph. So we have found ways to connect the dots, structure our knowledge by asking the right questions. Everything comes at a cost. Not all of them comes with a free plan. Most of those things that I've mentioned above, except image occlusion and portals, everything is available in the free plan. So what's the differences? I'll be brutally honest with you because we want to save our spicy dominoes. The pro plan is $6 a month, and then the lifelong learner is 5 years of cloud storage plus everything from the pro plan for $300. You get functions such as templates, pins, adding emojis, PDF annotation, graph, image occlusion, the search portal, and custom hotkeys. As a college student, I think it is totally worth it for the PDF annotation. I can chug in any electric PowerPoints or textbooks. I can highlight them everything on the spot. There are some downsides with this. It comes with a lot of app dependence. Since those documents are uploaded to Remnote, I'm not sure how you can get data and highlights out of the PDF uploader. In Remnote, when you highlight something, it generates an automatic code where you can click the reference from your notes and it directly brings you to the location of the highlight. And I have no idea how other apps are going to read that. I would say you can opt for Obsidian because Obsidian, everything is in Markdown. And let's flip it around, and instead of just looking for the perfect method, I would just execute. Learning from experience and failures and mistakes when it is your own pain is the best. During the meantime, go sharpening your note-taking skills with this video on how I take lecture notes during class. Happiness is a skill, and don't believe in what you think. Bye bye, I'll see you guys next time. Thank you for watching!